Hi, let us discuss about the first rate function, that is internal energy. Now, what is the internal energy? See, every substance has a definite amount of energy, and which is called as a internal energy or the intrinsic energy. So I write over here, so it is a internal energy. What is internal energy? It is an energy possessed by a, first thing, it is energy possessed by a substance. Okay, so energy possessed, it is a sum of all form of the energy. Second point I can write, it is a sum of all forms of energy. Like sum of all forms of energy means, first is a translational energy. Like particles will be there, it will be moving in a straight line. Energy possessed by particle moving in straight line. Okay, this is also known as a kinetic energy. Okay, next is rotational energy. Okay, rotational, this is due to the rotation of the molecule, rotational energy. A third is vibrational energy. Fourth is electronic energy. And fifth, we can write a potential energy. Now this is due to the interaction with the other particles. This is due to interaction with other particles. So this sum of all forms of energy is called as a internal energy of a system. Third point I will write here, on top I will write about the internal energy, that it is a state function. It is a state function. Third is, it is a state function. So what is the meaning of state function? As learned earlier, the value of which depends upon the only on the initial and the final state, and not by the path by which the change is brought. So here it is a state function. Then internal energy is sum of all forms of the energy, but the absolute value of the internal energy cannot be found out. Fourth point I will write, that exact value of internal energy cannot be found out. Okay, reason is that it is energy due to a translational, it is energy due to a constituent particle, and to get the energy of those constituent particle, it is very difficult, right? So absolute or exact value of the internal energy cannot be found out. And I will write in bracket, not required also. But change in internal energy could be found out. Fifth point I will write, change in internal energy could be found out. We can calculate this change found out. Now how the internal energy can be changed? Sixth is, internal energy changes, one, One, when work is done on or by the system. Okay. When heat is transferred from system to surrounding and vice versa means exchange of the heat or from the surrounding to the system. Third is when matter leaves or enters the system. So these are the conditions where we can get the change in the internal energy. So I will write over here one equation how the change in internal energy can be brought. So delta U, change in internal energy, that is delta U. Like when we will get this delta U, U is the sum of all forms of the energy, but change in internal energy, that is delta U, right? Delta U, when work is done on the system or by the system, accordingly the sign convention is going to change, or when heat is transferred from surrounding to the system or from the system to surrounding, so accordingly the sign convention is also going to change over here. So this is what the delta U is equal to. Q plus W, W plus Q, one and same, you can write this, this sounds good, Q plus W. So how we bring about a change in the internal energy is either supplying heat or absorbing, supplying a heat to the system or removing heat from the system or doing work on the system or by doing the work by the system, right? So this is the thing, or we can do both these things, then also the internal energy will be changed. Now this equation is also known as a first law of thermodynamics. Now what is the first law of thermodynamics? First law of thermodynamics is same as a law of conservation of energy. Okay, understand this. Law is also the conservation of energy, which governs the transfer of the energy between the system and the surrounding. This law, this first law of thermodynamics, there is law of conservation of energy. This law governs the transfer of energy between system and surrounding. Okay, now condition. Again, let's talk about the condition. There are different ways to express this. This could be written this way also. Delta U is equal to Q. What is work done? Work done is minus P delta V. Right? I can write it this way also. Right? Since work done is equal to minus P delta V. Now for an adiabatic process. For adiabatic process, what will be internal energy change? For adiabatic process, what is that? Q is equal to zero. There is no transfer of the energy, or we'll write dq, a difference in the energy is equal to zero. Q is equal to zero, or okay, we'll write this as a Q is equal to zero. So delta U is equal to Q plus W, right? So for the adiabatic process, this is zero. So delta U will be is equal to work done. So change in the internal energy will be is equal to what? Work done for the adiabatic process. Now for a isochoric process, isochoric process means
change in volume is zero, means at constant volume, at constant volume, volume of the system is not changing. Now you tell me, if volume is not changing, there is no compression or expansion, work done will be is equal to zero. We can prove this mathematically also. So we'll start with this. Delta U is equal to Q plus W. So Q is equal to what? W is equal to what? Minus P delta V. Now for this, for an isochoric process, difference in the volume is zero because volume is not changing, right? So what I'll write? Q minus P into zero. So delta U is equal to Q minus zero. So delta U will be is equal to Q. So for the isochoric process, delta U is equal to Q, and for the adiabatic process, delta U is equal to W. Let us solve one problem based on this concept. So here is the question. Question asked is, express the change in internal energy of a system when first A is no heat is absorbed by the system from the surrounding, where the system from the surrounding work is done on the system. What type of wall does the system have? Second, ask is no work is done on the system, but Q amount of heat is absorbed out from the system and given to the surrounding. What type of wall does the system have? And W amount of work is done by the system, and Q amount of heat is supplied to the system. So in every case, I need to write a delta U relation, the internal energy. For first, for A question, delta U, you can give a try to this question. You have to write the equation for all these three conditions. Okay, you can also comment me in a comment section. So delta U is equal to what? Here first is no heat is supplied, means this is the equation, no? Delta U is equal to Q plus W. This is the equation which we are going to take. No heat is supplied means Q is zero. So what is that? What remains? Just W. In second case B, no work is done on the system, but Q amount of the heat is taken out from the system and given to the surrounding. Now you tell me what it would be. Delta U is equal to Q or a minus Q. See, heat is lost by the system. You can see over here, Q amount of heat is taken from the system and given to the surrounding. Heat is transferred from the system to the surrounding. So delta U is equal to minus Q. And last, work W amount of work is done by the system and Q amount of heat is supplied to the system. So what would be the, okay, two things before we go to the C. There is one more thing. What type of wall does the system have? If system is not absorbing heat, or there is no transfer of the heat from the system to the surrounding, or the surrounding to the system, walls are adiabatic walls, or insulated walls. Okay, here heat is absorbed, only thing work is not done. So what kind of walls are these? Here also the question asked, option B. What type of wall does a system have? Walls are diathermic conducting walls. Okay, and here see, delta U will be is equal to what? W amount of work is done by the system, means W will be minus or plus. It will be minus W, because since work is done by the system, and Q amount of heat is supplied to the system, so therefore plus Q, or we can write this way, Q minus W. So these are the way in which all these equations could be represented. So read this question. You can also give a try to this question. Question asked is, a gas absorbs 120 joule of heat and expands against the external pressure of 1.1 atmosphere from a volume of 0.5 liter to 2 liter. What is the change in internal energy? So change in internal energy formula is this: delta U is equal to Q plus W. Q we are having, what is Q is equal to? 120 joule, right? 120 joule means I am going to put this to be in 120 only, because system is absorbing a heat, system is not losing a heat, so positive value only. But what we need to find is W, right? So what is that W first?
What is that W? So let's find W. What is W? W is equal to minus P delta V. Work done is equal to minus P delta V. So here, what is the external pressure? 1.1 atmosphere. 1.1 atmosphere. And what is the volume? Final minus initial. It is a expansion, right? Expands. So it is an expansion. Final is 2.0 and this is 0.5. So minus 1.1 into 1.5, right? So this comes to answer minus 1.65 liter atmosphere. So 1 liter atmosphere is equal to what? How many joules? 101.3 joules, right? So if I convert this, so 165 into 101.3 joules, this, see, I want this answer to be in joule because Q is in joule, right? Both the quantities should be in joule. So answer comes to be 167 minus 167.45 joule, 167.145 joule. This is what the answer is of the work done, right? So delta U will be is equal to what? Delta U, since heat is absorbed, it is positive only. Work is done by the system. So how much is that work I am getting? Expansion. So minus 167.145. So answer, final answer comes to minus 47.14. Minus 47.14 joule. This is the internal energy change for this.